fellas. Canada, New York, Pacific Northwest, and fabricated to finished products in places like Virginia, Alabama, California, the international activities. The high dollar and our free and open trade policies lured a flood of imported semi-fabricated products. Industry shipments reached a record high in 1987, and we expect yet another record to be set in 1988 for the industry this year and in recent years. Reynolds Metals Company's total export shipments last year running 78% ahead of last year. Consumer foil is showing a 62% increase, and other consumer and packaging related foil products are up 100%.
My great honor to introduce the President of the United States, Ronald Reagan. Fascinating, and there's much that I want to say, because I think I've seen a magic show already today, and I realize I'm only alone. Today, in my for the whole of 1987, such growth in the fifth year of an expansion probably also belongs in the record books. But I don't think one of those 64 months has gone by without some expert or some politician predicting an imminent disaster. Sometimes we'll be lucky and escape only with a recession. I'm sorry, but it seems to me that these people are out of touch. During the Great Depression, the prediction of prosperity just around the corner became a point of ridicule. Reverse is true today. We will be answering the next one. Said, what about the kind words? He said, don't eat them eggs. Our administration has no higher priority. They must keep evolving as they encounter contrary evidence. But the mythmakers don't give up. The three big ones today are the deindustrialization of America and manufacturing costs. And the economist Warren Brooks, predicting we will make a shift to an export-led economy, said that 88 would end with a bang. And you think this would all be cause for rejoicing in Washington, not among our critics. They've been predicting that could squelch productivity, destroy American competitiveness, and make all their doomsday myths a reality. In an apparent attempt to import you may have been reading lately that the trade bill has been talked about. Senator Reed Smoot, Representative Willis Hall, and the collapse of the world trading system and helped send America into the decline of the Great Depression, the Smoot-Hall tariff. But both of them felt that a bit of demagoguing about trade was good politics. Certainly didn't get them in the history books. What many people don't realize is that they were both thrown out of office 2 years later when the voters had time to see the effects of their bill. Protectionism, production and communication, not mercantilist national economics, shrinking behind tariff barriers. That's why we pushed for a new gag round, which has now been launched, to negotiate the most ambitious multinational trade agenda in history. This took some doing at the economic summits that we hold each year. But today is part of a larger picture. The world economy is in the midst of a profound transformation. It's been called the information age, the computer age, the technological revolution. She has in the last 20 years. He says a Rolls Royce today would cost less than $3. It would get 3 million miles to the gallon. It would deliver enough horsepower to drive an ocean liner, and six of them would fit on the head of a pin. This is more than simply a productivity explosion. Operating in the mysterious realm of quantum physics, today's computer will get all the way. this happened to a fellow, and this is their story that they tell, this joke. That this man, he laid down his money, and then the fellow that was in charge said to him, okay, come back in 10 years and get your car. And he said, morning or afternoon? And the fellow behind the counter said, well, 10 years from now, what difference does it make? And he said, well, the plumber's coming in the morning.
Thank you.